Hi there, my name is Samir Bhagwat, and I'm with Intrepid Control Systems. I'm Director of Quality Assurance and Engineering Services. I'm here gonna talk about service-oriented architectures and specifically about some IP. With the new technologies for the ADAS and autonomy, we do see need of high data transmits and a complex data type communications. With traditional signal-based communications, there are certain limitations, and some IP and service-oriented architectures try to address those needs. Intrepid has been part of providing products and solutions for some IP, and essentially, Vehicle Spy X and neoVI are the products which have our own some IP service discovery stack. This means when you are going to test your architectures for some IP, these products could be helpful for you. So this is neoVI Pi, which has a Raspberry Pi along with our CAN interface hardware. And this is one of the devices I would highly recommend to use for profiling and running your some IP stacks. It has Linux because there is Raspbian in there. And this device, along with a media converter and a switch, can form a good platform to architect your some IP running inside an ECU. Along with this, I would recommend using Vehicle Spy X. Vehicle Spy X has our own service discovery stack, and it is also accessible through Python interface. As you know, Vehicle Spy X is our cross-platform new modern architecture bus analyzer, and it has our own AUTOSAR comm stack for communication network testing. Conceptually, a service-oriented architecture is different than signal-oriented architecture because here there is a process where you can discover what services are offered by which endpoints, and that is called service discovery. Once service discovery happens, a provider and a consumer establish a contract, a runtime dynamic contract, where a provider is gonna provide needed services to a consumer ECU. These all architectural changes are driven because of things like zonal architectures and software-defined vehicles. So service-oriented communication is the future, we believe, and with the new zonal architecture, and software-defined vehicle architectures allows, with the help of the OTA, post-production update of the vehicles, which is absolutely possible today because of technologies like service-oriented architectures and some IP. Some IP is something not very new, and BMW, in fact, introduced that in 2011 as a middleware to do transactions when they wanted to have things which are independent of underlying hardware layers. More traction of this technology has happened in recent years when actually AUTOSAR specified it very clearly and in the specifications in November release, the recent November release, they have a major change and upgrade to some IP specifications, including in-service discovery. And AUTOSAR remains on the forefront of the for specifications on some IP. And that is the technology currently every OEM is following for service-oriented architecture. The main part is the description of the entire some IP architecture and how the data is transacted is very well defined in AUTOSAR AR-XML. Intrepid supports AR-XML technology, and Intrepid supports some IP through different product lines. One of the talk I have today is about how to use our media converters and switch to have different endpoints talk to each other on service-oriented architecture. Thanks for watching. This is Samir Bhagwat from Intrepid Control Systems.